leveled right hand of Raju prevail.
I would imagine, yeah, we're done with the strike. Tonon wants to get the win, get this to the ground as quickly as possible, and lock on a submission and finish Raju, because he's not going down from the shots that Tonin's landing.
This is Tonin's territory. Top position on the ground. So many options available for the grappling megastar.
Raju's got to start pushing that head down. He can't allow Tonon to drive his head up into his face like that. That's uncomfortable, but it's also going to control his position. Raju's got to start pushing that face away and create a little bit of space. Tonon sucked his hips away. Now he's easily able to transition into, what's he got, full mount there? Almost half guard, but easily cuts through that. Look, here comes a triangle possibly.
Raju has shown his toughness to survive several heel hit attempts thus far. The arm is pinned, the face is exposed, and there's a couple of left hands to the shoulder. There's another plaza over the shoulder, locks it up to Raju, and Raju's free again!
Yep, Tonon, stand back up. Good job again.
The resilience of this Indian is phenomenal.
He might be losing on the scorecards, but he is winning fans worldwide by surviving Garry Tonon's submission attempts.
Escapes are plenty from Rahul Raju of India. And Tonon back to dancing, back to switching stance. Raju's gonna try and catch him with that piston-like right hand. And Tonon circles off to his right, going counterclockwise. Raju probing with the lead hand. The left to probe, the right to damage. There's the right. Tonon on the balls of his feet. Comes out the jab. There's a hook, but the shoulder protection up in a hurry. Raju should have thrown the right hand. It was a golden opportunity. He may rue the missed opportunity. Double leg takedown from Tonon.
Yeah, that's what Tonon was talking about all week. It's his shoot boxing, putting these things together. And he considers a takedown just one of the many weapons in his arsenal in combinations. One, two, takedown, get back up, ground and pound, consistently pressuring Raju. Now he's gonna take the back. These guys are slippery now. Looks like he's gonna take the back there. He might go for an arm. Look how he's isolating the arm there. He's trapped that arm. There's a possible scramble if Raju can turn in. He's gotta go chest to chest to get out of this. Tonon's got great back control, though. Look how he isolates that arm. Traps the arm with the leg. Now he's going to be able to go underneath the chin.
Raju in big trouble!
Look how Tonon hides the hand so Raju can't defend it.
In big trouble!
That's a face crank. That's nasty. Raju fighting his leg.
Second round of three. Now, once again, both men said it would not go past two rounds. This is the round that Sung Jong Lee said he would knock out Garry Tonon in.
Sung Jong Lee's got to put that jab out there. He's got to ask Garry Tonon's closing the distance. Sung Jong Lee's got to utilize the jab. Garry Tonon's used like throwing way too many jabs.
Counter right hand there from Sung Jong Lee. The head movement again from Tonon. The boxing has improved out of sight, particularly the jab of Tonon. High up against the balls of his feet, working the kicking arsenal now. There's a front kick to the midsection from the American. Dances back to center cage. Outside leg kick, inside leg kick. A striking display here, 101 from Garry Tonon.
This is a very different striker from the second time that we saw him.
You know what, Mitch, we're seeing the kicks here from Tonon, but Sung Jong Lee began his martial arts career in the national Korean art of Taekwondo, an art renowned for its kicking arsenal.
And he hasn't thrown a kick yet.
Nope. 2016 Naganogi Grappling Championship at under 160 pounds. Sung Jong Lee, purple belt in BJJ, loves the heel hook. Imagine slapping a heel hook on Garry Tonon. Don't think it'll happen. Let's see if he can swing for a knockout here in the second round. Garry Tonon, look at the movements on Tonon. Circles off clockwise, now drifts to his right. Full of confidence oozing out of every pore here for Garry Tonon. The jab, and oh, look at the evasion of the takedown. That was sweet. That was slick.
That was beautiful.
Up to finish.
Slit out of the way. Oh, nice little butterfly sweep there, but he's giving up the game.
Oh, this is trouble.
Don't want to give your neck to Garry Tonon. He's going to keep adjusting until he finds it. But Sung Jung Lee did a good job there of swinging over into half guard. Got into side control, but look at Garry Tonon. He adjusted it in. Oh, that's nasty.
Oh, hold on. Wait a minute. Let me put some Tonon in it. Go. Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chilson, Misha Tate with you. Tonon moving well early on. Has improved his boxing out of sight in those last four matches. But let's see how he handles the power of Nakahara. Should Nakahara touch him, he tries with an early uppercut.
You know, Nakahara's got a very heavy left side. He's got a heavy left punch and a heavy left kick. So it's going to be key for Garry Tonon to try to keep his head on the outside lead hand of Nakahara. So that's what that head movement is. He's going to constantly be trying to shift his head to the outside hand of Nakahara. But Nakahara's got a good right hook too.
Constantly switching stance here in the opening stage of the first round is Garry Tonon. If it goes to ground, both men are very well equipped, but of course Tonon Gowder is a genius in the Gowder at the moment. This is trouble for Nakahara.
This is Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.